Today I'm going to show how to get code completion and debugger support for Rust right inside Visual Studio Code. It's mostly pretty easy, there's just a few plugins to install. There are a couple of minor quirks, I'll point that out as we go along. So here we're on a fresh machine, a Mac. I've already done a couple of setup tasks. I've installed Visual Studio Code from the DMG. I also used the RustUp script to install the Rust stable toolchain. And when you're doing a fresh installation of macOS, you need to accept the Xcode license for the command line tools. So previously I ran a cargo build from the command line, and that prompted me to accept those terms. But apart from those basic things, it's basically a clean slate. So I want to do some Rust coding, so I'm going to make an application called Numbers. So I'll initialize the project with cargo. Numbers. And open it in VS Code. Now, this program is just going to generate and print a couple of random numbers. Now, out of the box, VS Code doesn't understand TOML files, but it prompts me with an extension that will help. I'm going to search the marketplace. Yeah, sure, let's go ahead and install Better TOML. Great, that looks better. I'll go ahead and add my dependency on the rand crate so that I can generate some random numbers. Now, over in main.rs, I'm going to do a couple of things. I'm going to generate a random int, and a random float as well. I can't quite remember the syntax. We'll get to that in a second. Random int. F32 equals something, print line, random, float, if. Okay, so what's that function that I want to use from the rand crate? I could go and look at the documentation, but, you know, I'd also like to use some autocomplete here. Let's install the Rust language server and the RLS plugin for VS Code. That plugin can do all the work for me, so I'll skip straight to that. Plugins, RLS, here we are, Rust language support, code completion, IntelliSense, I'll hit install there. When it starts asking me questions, do I want to install RLS? Yes, I actually do, so I'll click yes. And as you can see, it's using RustUp in the background to pull in that information that it needs to be able to provide the code completion. And now it's building, you can see in the bottom left here. This will take a moment because it's downloading crates, making sure that that's all good to go. Waiting. Okay. Ooh, I've got red now. Let's close this for a moment. So, there are a few things to notice here. It's identified a compile error because I didn't have a semicolon over here. And I can hover over things to check the documentation. Rand, utilities for random number generation. And now, when I type, it starts giving me auto-completion, so I can see that the function is actually called random. Fantastic. So without having to go and browse the docs myself, I can get my random int and my random float and print them out. So does it actually work? CD numbers cargo run. Note that the compilation that the RLS did was all sort of kept separate, so when I run it from the command line, it does its own build separately. And we can see that it worked. Random int, random float. A word of warning here, if you're using the Rust nightly toolchain, you can tell the RLS plugin to use the nightly through VS Code preferences. The trouble is that not every release of the nightly toolchain has a valid build of the RLS component. If you update your nightly at random, you'll probably find that RLS sometimes breaks. Fortunately, there is a website you can visit to see whether RLS is built for a particular date of the nightly. I'll put a link to this page in the video description. So there's a page for Linux and other ones for Apple, so you can see whether RLS is there for a given date or not. Cool. Second tip, RLS sometimes gets confused and stops working. it gets stuck and just doesn't show you up-to-date errors. So 99% of the time you can fix this by doing reload window. So on Mac that's Control-Shift-P, reload window, and it will reload back to the same place and also restart RLS. So that usually gets RLS going again. Once or twice I've had a runaway RLS process in the background eating all my CPU and RAM. It's uncommon, but if it happens you might need to track down that process and kill it in Activity Monitor or Task Manager depending on your platform. Great, that's improved the VS Code experience a lot already. What if I want to set a breakpoint and examine my variables? I can do that right here too. This calls for another plugin, and this one is not specific to Rust. It's called CodeLLDB. So I'll go ahead and install that. Okay, that's installed. Now I can go ahead and use the menu, which is cut off in the video. Sorry, I'll put a breakpoint here and go debug, start debugging. Yeah, it's an LLDB environment, and there's a problem. I haven't actually provided a launch configuration. So, how do I do that? Ah, would you like to generate launch configurations for its targets? Yes. And here we go. It seems to have generated something for me that looks kind of right, I guess. So I'll try again. Back to main.rs, build, start debugging. It's doing something. It's asking for my password. Okay, and just like that, we're now debugging. I don't have any local variables yet, so let's keep stepping. Okay, I has been set. Step a bit more. F's been set as well. I can get console output at the bottom in the debug console, and I can see my call stack on the left. So that includes multiple threads if I have them. So with that small collection of plugins, now I have a pretty full-featured Rust IDE that I can use on Mac, Windows, and Linux, and it's all open source. Great stuff. Till next time, cheerio.